A new gene therapy can reverse hearing loss. Is this big news for tinnitus treatment? Earlier this year, Akouos, a genetic medicine company, announced that it had restored hearing in its first test subject, an 11-year-old child with profound hearing loss. Scientists did this by specifically treating a mutation of a gene called OTIF, one of around 150 genes associated with childhood hearing loss. The OTIF mutation affects approximately 200,000 people worldwide and comes with a high risk of deafness. This new study builds on similar research from Harvard Medical School in 2022 to form an encouraging picture of a future where hearing loss isn't just preventable and treatable, but actually reversible. As a tinnitus specialist, this is really exciting because most cases of tinnitus are caused by hearing loss. I want to explain more about what this means for tinnitus. But I also want to stress that you don't need to wait for the next big study to lower your tinnitus and get back to doing the things that you love. I love new research and new tools, but there's clear evidence that what's called tinnitus retraining therapy, or TRT for short, can help you today. If you want to learn more, get a free consultation with a Treble Health audiologist by clicking the link. But we still want more research, so back to OTIF. This kind of mutation is so rare that the exact genetic treatment the researchers used can't be applied to your average person struggling with hearing loss. But the findings are nonetheless extremely encouraging. Here's why. The OTIF gene is located in the inner ear, where it manufactures a protein that is key to transmitting sensory signals from the ear to the brain. As a result, most people who have an OTIF-related mutation have normal functioning ears. But the sensory signals fail to make it from the ear to the brain, and thus can't be processed. This causes severe or even profound deafness. Both the Akouos and the Harvard studies treated this with gene therapy, in which they essentially inserted copies of normal OTIF genes that are encased in a viral vector, which is a non-disease-causing virus. The virus basically mimics the gene and starts producing the missing protein and sending it to the inner ear, with the goal of restoring the sensory connection between the ear and the brain. The OTIF gene is so large that it required two separate injections to deliver it in full. In the Akouos study, as I mentioned, an 11-year-old with hearing loss from birth had their hearing restored across frequencies just 30 days after the treatment. In the Harvard study, researchers tested six children with the OTIF genetic mutation. Four of those children had cochlear implants, but without using those implants, they were functionally deaf, meaning that they're not able to hear unless they're using those implants. 4 to 6 weeks after the procedure, researchers saw a progressive improvement, and the children with cochlear implants could turn the devices off and experienced partially restored hearing, including being able to recognize speech in a noisy room and talk on the telephone. The younger participants started showing the ability to recognize speech and even began to verbalize words. The sum total, 5 of the 6 children who underwent this genetic therapy experienced improved hearing over the 26-week trial period. This is the first genetic therapy to successfully treat inherited deafness, and researchers were absolutely thrilled, as was I, to see the results. But if you don't have the OTIF gene, you may be wondering, well, what does this mean for me? Well, as one researcher put it, it's a new dawn for hearing loss. That's because, as I mentioned, over 150 genes are associated with childhood hearing loss, and a growing body of research suggests that some adult hearing loss is also associated with genetics. So if the OTIF gene can be treated by essentially replacing the mutated gene with a working version of it, this opens up the door for using gene therapy to treat a much wider variety of other genes associated with deafness. Of course, each individual gene presents its own specific obstacles, so we'll need to wait for a lot more research to know if this process can be replicated in other genes associated with hearing loss. Maybe your tinnitus is caused by hearing loss or by physical problems in your jaw or neck, or maybe you don't know. Either way, you don't need to wait for gene therapy to reduce your tinnitus. While I'm always on the lookout for better and more effective treatments to refer my patients to, we have some really incredible tools backed by really strong science at Treble Health. Maybe you think your tinnitus is too far gone, or if you've been frustrated by how unhelpful other doctors are, I want to assure you it can get better, and you can start that process by scheduling a free consultation with the incredible team at Treble Health. We are all tinnitus specialists and here to help you on your journey. The link is on the screen.